When ninth-ranked Cisco and Ballinger play tomorrow night, it'll be the 17th time the two programs have met up. They're fairly new opponents to one another, and Cisco's won the past six meetings, but none of those previous matchups have quite the stakes like this year's. In the first game of district for both teams, but very well could be the deciding factor on who comes out on top of District 4-3A. With a 3-0 record and one of the best quarterbacks in West Texas, the Bearcats have high expectations for this season and so far have lived up to them. But they also haven't faced a team quite like the Lobos. Their only loss of the season came against Wall. And if it weren't for multiple turnovers in that game, they might have won. So the way that both teams have played so far and the strength of the remaining district opponents, the idea that this game is crowning the district champion isn't too far-fetched.
Beating teams like Cisco, you know, that's something that you'll always remember, and it's going to give us more confidence to keep improving, you know, throughout the year. You know, we want to be district champions. Yes, we want to beat the Cisco Lobos. We want to beat Anson. We want to beat everybody in our district, and we want to, you know, make a deep run in the playoffs. But right now, we got to take 1 week at a time, and we've done a good job focusing on Cisco, and we just got to go get it executed for four quarters.
We like to say it's a district championship by week four. And whoever's ready and prepared the most for this game should be ending up as a district champion in the end.
Well, we're pretty much playing for the district championship tomorrow night because we're the top two teams in the district. And to win tomorrow night, in front of, especially in front of Ballinger, it'd be huge, for not just for us, but for the community too.